Picture this. It's Monday morning. You open your inbox and you see a message from your manager. We're moving to a new platform and training starts next week. You've never heard of it? You Google it, it's complex, it's powerful, and now it's your responsibility. Does that sound familiar? Whether it's a new programming language, a cloud tool, or even an AI framework, technology is moving faster than ever. And the ability to learn quickly, it's not just a nice to have, it's a career superpower. Your ability to learn can be your edge. Now let's take a look at four tips that can allow you to efficiently master many new technologies. First, choose your expertise. You can't learn everything. Before you dive into the latest tech trend, ask yourself, what's your lane? Are you a developer? Are you a data analyst, a designer, or a product manager? Choosing your area of expertise helps you filter out the noise and focus on what you need to learn. Focus on technologies that align with your goals and amplify your strength. Start with what you're already familiar with and then dive deeper. If you've been asked to test a new agentic AI platform and you see out-of-the-box tools for a software you already use those as building blocks and start there. Building on what's familiar will help you get your goals accomplished even faster. Next, set a goal. Goals give your learning direction. They turn vague curiosity into concrete progress, and they help you measure what you've actually learned. Let's say we want to develop an agent and test new agentic AI frameworks. We could create a very specific goal that says build an agent, and we want this agent to generate AI newsletters, and we want to do that using two tools. We're going to call two tools, and we're going to do that in 2 weeks. Now we've now created a goal that is SMART. What does SMART stand for? That is specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. So as we break down our original goal, we were very specific, just building an agent, generating AI newsletters. So we specifically said what we wanted this agent to do. We can measure that and call it a success if it's calling two tools. And we are making sure that this is achievable based on what we already know how to do. We can learn this new topic and do it in 2 weeks. It's achievable. It's relevant to our current job. Maybe we are a developer, and this is something our team will be asked to do. So everything we're learning is going to tie back and actually apply to what we need to do in the future. And then we are time bounding this within 2 weeks, and we can get that done. So think about it like training for a race. You don't want to just start running. You actually want to train with that finish line in mind, and these SMART goals will help you to get there. So, third, practice. Practice, practice, practice. Learning by doing, it's the fastest way to master tech. So don't just watch, actually build, write, code, and experiment. Contribute to open source. Find different hackathons in your community and think about the way you can actually give back as you're doing this, right? So look for problems, maybe on your team, even in your daily life, and think about how you can improve that and practice what you're learning. It's a great creative way to actually apply what you learn and give meaning behind that. And finally, follow up. So the learning doesn't stop when you've completed your goal or task. Think about how you can continue and push that even further. So ask yourself, once you build that AI agent and reach that goal, how could it be better? Maybe you integrate new tools. And so now instead of two tools, you're looking at 3, 4, or 5. Maybe you're doing that even quicker in a shorter time period. So turn that into long-term learning and long-term skill. And one great way to continue learning and to follow up is actually attending events like conferences, giving you a way to share what you learn, share your expertise, or even doing virtual events. And there's many great resources out there where you can sign up for different newsletters to regularly get learning sent to your inbox, as well as YouTube channels, blogs, etc. Different ways you can follow experts to really expand and build your knowledge on topics and even build your credibility by applying what you've learned. So to recap, when learning any new technology, we want to look at our expertise, set a very smart goal, practice what we've learned, and then finally, follow up and stay connected in the industry. These four tips will help you master any new technology faster, smarter, and with confidence. What tips are helping you learn the latest in technology? And where do you stay connected? Let us know in the comments below.